Hello, welcome back to the channel and welcome to another wildlife photography video in glorious Norfolk. So I don't really like trespassing on private land, so what I decided to do was go on the Norfolk website and see some of the places I could sort of legally access. I know you can trespass legally, but I just from experience I'd rather not. So where I am at the moment is on a public footpath. I've got absolutely no idea where it goes. My car's parked just down there, as you can see. And already I've seen a jay that was just up in the tree just here. I've seen a kestrel and I'm sure I saw something else, possibly a buzzard. So yeah, I mean, already it seems pretty good. So what I intend to do, I'm now vlogging on the Lumix G80, and the reason I've switched from the GX80 to the G80 is because the G80 has the microphone input, which means I can use my Rode video micro on the top with the little wind muff. It just means we won't have the same wind noise as before. The only downside really is that I'll be using the GX80, which at the moment is on the floor. The only downside to that is that I don't particularly like the EVF on the GX80, particularly when you've got sort of light coming in from the sides and from the back. It's really hard to see the EVF, but needs must. So yeah, my first sort of intention is to head down over this way. I mean, I've already got a couple of nice shots just on the way here. Female blackbird, I've got another shot of, I think it might be a house martin. I'm not particularly hot on my birds, so I'll drop those pictures in and perhaps you can tell me in the comments. So yeah, let's enjoy this beautiful, beautiful spring day in Norfolk. Let's see what happens. So I've just walked a few hundred meters, haven't seen too much at the moment, although we are getting further away from the roads, so I expect to sort of see a bit more wildlife that way. I can see a hare just running in the field just over there, too far away for me to show you. So yeah, I've got some signs of what I presume to be roe deer tracks. So yeah, what I might do, I'm obviously quite, not exactly inconspicuous how I'm dressed at the moment. I'm gonna whack on the camouflage jacket and just start taking it a little bit more steady. Now, I was looking at getting the Peak Design Capture 3 as a way of, obviously I'm holding a vlogging camera, it's quite hard to access my photography camera. But what I've managed to do, if I can show you, I've managed to use my backpack strap the camera to my shoulder, and it kind of just hangs like that. So yeah, it's pretty cool. I mean, I'm walking around with a backpack with the 25mm f1.7 lens, spare batteries, all that good stuff, camouflage trousers. I'm obviously holding and walking with two cameras, and it's no real effort whatsoever, to be honest. So yeah, I absolutely love, I don't want to sound like a fanboy, because at the end of the day it really doesn't matter what camera you shoot with as long as it works for you, but I absolutely love using the Panasonic Lumix system. So yeah, let's be a little bit more hush-hush and carry on, because this is my absolute favorite type of wildlife photography. I absolutely love getting outside. I absolutely love exploring. There's a huge explorer inside of me. Maybe I'm related to Christopher Columbus, who knows. So I've just spotted a hare that's about 200 to 300 meters in front of me. I can't approach on this path because he'll obviously see me coming. But as you can see, you've got this sort of tree line that runs along to him. So I'm gonna use that as a form of cover, so I can hopefully get closer to him. So yeah, I'm gonna make my way down there and see how we get along. Looking at the timer on here, that was almost 20 minute experience just there. As you can see, if I use this camera and just zoom in, has he moved? No. Has he moved? After all that, where did he go? Oh no! No! So, I need to capture this. Right, okay. Scrap everything I just said. This is why he's moved. I went through all of that, getting beautiful portrait shots of him, getting as close as I could, and now he's having a fight with another hare just as I move away. Let's see if I can... Oh no, where are they gone? Oh, they're all the way over there. They're all the way over there. All right, let me just put this down and record this. All right, come on, 4K. Oh, come on, yes. Where are you? Where are you? There you are. Here you go. Let them have the fight. This is absolutely crazy. You come out to do wildlife photography and you don't have an absolute clue what's going to happen. Nothing planned, you can't script these sort of things. Which I guess is, this is where the joy comes from. But that's insane. That is absolutely insane. I took the time to sneak. It took me the best part of 20 minutes to get sort of all the shots that I wanted. And as I decide, okay, enough's enough, I'm going to go back, check how long I've been doing this for. It's one of those things. I could have got some really good shots of them fighting, potentially. But who's to know? The benefit of hindsight. Oh, I love wildlife. It is so cool. It is so cool. Yeah. I literally have no idea what the plan is now. I think potentially I'm going to spend maybe the next 10 minutes just in this position. I mean, obviously the hares were, you're looking at about 250, 300 meters away. They possibly might have gone into another field. I can't see any sign of them now. So yeah, I mean, that would have been absolutely amazing to get, you know, some pictures of them scrapping. But yeah, I think it's coffee time. And yeah, hope for some more action. So I hope that's been for entertaining this for you as it has for me, because it's just, this is why I come out and do this sort of thing. No way. No freaking way. Muntjac. This is just one of those days. This is absolutely one of those days. I cannot believe this. Every now and then, you will have the most dry day ever, where you see absolutely no wildlife whatsoever. And then you have one of these days, like today, where it all just comes to you. This is an absolutely crazy, crazy, crazy day. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna chill out and wait for the wildlife to come to me. So this is a good example of why you need patience as a wildlife photographer. I'm basically laying down in a small little kind of dip in the ground, and the hares have made an appearance. They're both about 200 meters away from me, so at the moment too far away to get some good shots. They're not actually doing anything at the moment, but I'm just gonna stay here. The explorer is saying move on, go check out, you know, what lies beyond. But the fact is, the sun is sort of above me to my right, so it's lighting up the field just here quite nicely. So yeah, it would definitely make sense to stay here and try and get the shots of a bit of hare action, because I've not achieved that before. Right, it's starting to do things again. Thank you. I decided to stay put in this location, and the hares have been obviously competing for the females, and they've been chasing each other, and they got so close to me. That's absolutely incredible. I need to whack up some of the shots now. Honestly, I don't think you could get shots this close, this intense. I'm pretty speechless, absolutely speechless. This has been amazing. The hare are just, they've just popped into this undergrowth, this sort of bushy bit here. Obviously they chased each other into that. What I need to do now is set myself up. Oh, this ground is so hard. Set myself up with a clear line of sight where I think or hope that they'll come from. I need to keep my voice down because I've got no idea where they are. This could be so cool. Shit. Watch this. I'm gonna spin there. Close to wild hares in my life. It was absolutely incredible just how he, it's almost like he posed for me. So yeah, absolutely incredible. Apologies if this episode has been quite long, but I think the plan now is to pack up. I think you can be almost too selfish, or what's the word, you can almost ask for too much. Nature's given me so much today, and I think I should go home, spend time with the family, and just reflect on this awesome, incredible day. So yeah, I'll put all the pictures at the end of the video. And yeah, if this is anything to go by, these vlogs are just gonna keep getting better and better. I really hope you've enjoyed the video. If you have, please, if you're a subscriber, please do me the honor of giving me a thumbs up, leaving a comment down below. It really does help the channel grow. I'm not looking to be a big YouTuber with millions of subscribers, but to get, you know, a few eyeballs on my videos would be nice. So yeah, awesome day, and I'll see you on the next one. Take care.